All right. Well, let's try this again. Hey, everybody, it's Friday night and it's time for the ASEA 5. Tonight, we're the ASEA 5, the fabulous ASEA 5 Plus. We've got a fabulous show for you tonight because we have some very special people on. As you know, you probably know the regulars. I'm Dr. Maureen Hayes from Galveston, Texas. We have Jim and Ann Glenn from San Antonio, Texas. Jim's our money man, and Ann is our nutritionist and our physical fitness person. And then we also have Dr. Lee Osler, our dentist extraordinaire from the state of Washington. He's the former president and founder of AOSH, which is the American Academy of Oral Systemic Health. So he brings a fund of knowledge to this. And what we do here every Friday night is we share information on redox signaling molecules, which is probably one of the most significant discoveries of our lifetime. What it does is we replenish it. It's a bioreplenishment agent that we put in, we ingest it, we smear it on the skin. You'll learn a little bit more about this later. And it actually boosts our natural reserves, helps our cells to do their job better. And so we look and feel younger, heal faster, run faster, all sorts of things. Anything that your body is meant to do, it's going to augment and enhance. And so tonight we have a bevy of beautiful nurses here tonight to share their stories and to give you some tips on how to best use these redox molecules. Let me just make a little disclaimer real quick. We are medical professionals, but this is not a medicine. It is not meant to treat, cure, diagnose anything. All it does is, as I said, helps your cells do their job better. So let me introduce our ladies.
Well, hey, real quick, I'm going to make the announcement. I've got a special song for tonight. Because it in the United States, it's Memorial Day weekend. Memorial Day is Monday. In the last 5 minutes, I'm going to play a very special song it's our ASEA song and just a very touching song. And I believe everybody's going to love it. So stick around for the last 5 minutes before we shut down. Go ahead.
Absolutely. Thank you, Jim, for that. And yes, happy Memorial Day weekend. And let's remember all the people who gave the ultimate sacrifice. Amen. And I'd like to take a moment just to thank all the men and women in the service. I know this is not your weekend, but you know, we never thank you enough. So thank you. And we have somebody right here, Kathy Davis, is retired from the Army. So thank you for your service, Kathy. So just to go around the room of nurses, we have Suzanne Truax, who is a nurse from Sugar Land, Texas, right down the road from me. Doria Stewart, who's from Atlanta, Georgia. Kathy Davis, who's from San Antonio. And Nelda Castilla. You're from Waco, correct, Nelda?
Lubbock, Texas.
Lubbock. I live in Texas, but I don't really know the geography that well. It's a big state. I haven't gotten very far. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with having each lady come on and share a little bit about her background, how she got introduced to ASEA, what she has seen. If each of you has a special story to share, that would be fantastic. And then we're going to have a question and answer session. So remember, no diseases, please. And then, of course, we will wrap it up with Jim's special song. So, Suzanne, you want to take it away?
You're muted, Suzanne.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Maureen. Yeah, Maureen and I have been friends since our big boys were just little boys. Long time. And so, let's see, I started my nursing career, I think, when I was 12 years old and the youngest volunteer at one of the oldest hospitals here in Houston. So I've had a huge passion for making a difference for people since I was young. And I went to nursing school in a community college here in Houston and quickly came back and worked at the hospital where I had been a junior volunteer and worked my way up to being director of home care at a very large hospital here in Houston and ran their home care program for all of Harris County and all of Fort Bend County. So I also became sort of had all kinds of certifications, loved teaching, but what I didn't like was all the paperwork. I really did not like that. I loved having time building relationships with families and truly making a difference for them. So a friend of mine introduced me to some wellness products about the time that my husband had been injured in an automobile accident and was paralyzed on one side of his body. And so it was because of those technologies that his body woke up in a very short period of time. And that's what opened my eyes to the wellness industry. So we started a wellness business then. And 6 years ago, Chris Gullo brought to my husband and I this technology, and he knew how passionate I was about making a difference for people and knew that I would be passionate about sharing this. And so my husband and I have enjoyed sharing this with people all over the world for the last 6 years.
That's fantastic. And I think we go back about 20 years, Suzanne. It's hard
to believe. I think even maybe more than that. Maybe.
It's been a long journey, but it's been a good
journey. Yes, my youngest one is 34 now. And so I think your little guy was 10 when we met each other, it seems like, when we went to Japan together.
Yeah. Well, he's 28 now and engaged. So yeah, they do grow up. It's amazing.
They do. Yeah.
It's crazy. So great to have you as part of the ASEA family now.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you for sharing. Doria, do you mind coming on and sharing with us a little bit? Tell us how you got involved and what you've seen so far.
Well, I'm so honored and thankful for you all inviting me on the ASEA 5. It's my favorite night of the week, so thank you. And I think last year we were all together, so it's like a reunion. So yes, I've been a registered nurse for close to 40 years. It will be, I guess, October of this year will be 40 years. I've been at the bedside as a nurse on the floor. I have worked 3 12-hour shifts a week. Most recently, I transitioned over to a doctor's office in December. And I had a very good friend of mine who's a dentist. Lee knows him very well. And he reached out to me to share with me about this technology. And I thought, you know, I'm not really sure if I'm interested in it, or you know, the science seemed like it was pretty complex. And I thought, you know, I'm not sure. So I kind of like just took a deep dive and did some research on my own. And I realized it works at the cellular level. And, you know, I have a history in my family of having bad cells in the breast and bad cells in the heart. And I really don't deal with any health challenges, but I thought, you know, I want to do everything possibly that I can to prevent any of those things happening in my life. You know, and then also as a nurse, you know, as all of us can allude to, is that I'm so, you know, ready to learn about new technologies just so that we can help our patients have better outcomes. And we know, as a lot of us have been nurses for a long time, we're seeing our patients, you know, on a lot of different things that cause other, you know, problems. And so that's what excited me, is, you know, seeing this technology and how I can help, you know, more people. I feel like I'm helping more people with this technology than I have in my 40 years of nursing.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Wow. That does say a lot. You know, it's because it's that ripple effect, right? You know, you help the person in front of you and they can turn around and help others as well. You know, so thank you for that, Doria. That was amazing. Kathy, would you like to share?
Sure. So it's hard. Jim knows it's hard for me to keep my story short because it is so long, but I'll do my best. So I would say about 20 years ago, so I have a medical story is what it is. So a little bit about myself. I took care of my sister who was special needs when I was young. So I kind of started off in the medical field at a very, very young age. And then I joined the military after I was out of my home and I became a medic, a registered EMT. Then in 94, I became an LVN. In 2000, I became an RN. In 2013, I became a nurse practitioner. So I've been in the medical field my whole life. I love caring for people. I love patients. I love all the whole age spectrum. I just love people. So anyway, about 20 years ago, when my daughter was 6 months old, I got hit with a bug. I was working in a nursing home covering because people were out sick. And I got hit with that bug and I just didn't recover from it very well. That time in my life, it changed everything. I started having problems with fatigue and weakness. My muscles would burn. My joints felt like they were old. They were stiff and hard to move. I didn't have any energy. I was so weak that when my daughter was a baby and she's crawling on the floor, you know how you have those little jumbo things like this and your baby crawls and plays underneath it? I didn't have the energy to sit there with her. But if I leaned against the wall, then I could sit there with her while she played. It was a stark difference from having been in the military and having a lot of energy to having a baby and not having any and being told, well, it's just because you had a baby. It's like, no, something's seriously wrong with me. So that was my life for a good 16 years of struggling with energy and fatigue and brain fog, amongst other things. So I've been in the military, and a lot of you know people in the military, sometimes we kind of come back with issues, and I've struggled with a lot of those issues in addition to everything else. So as a nurse, you find jobs that work with your illness, you know, and you kind of hide it at work, and then at home, you sleep and you rest. And I didn't have a lot of time for my family because I slept so much every night, and 4 hours on Saturday and 4 hours on Sunday, and very little time for family because I slept so much. So I thought, well, if I get more educated, then I won't be so physically, I won't be so tired. So I tried to get jobs that worked with that. Anyway, I'm just going to progress. So in all of my children's lives, they know sick mommy. They know tired mommy. They know fatigued mommy. They know mommy who can't go to activities or any of those things. So 27, I'm just going to fast forward to 2017. I'm a nurse practitioner, and I'm working part-time in an effort to have energy. You know, I stepped down from full-time, and I got a bug from a patient again, and I'm treated for that bug 3 times, and I don't improve. And the boss, the owner of the clinic, says, Kathy, you're too sick. You need to leave. You need to take care of yourself. So I go home thinking I'm recovering from an infection, but instead my whole adrenal system crashes. I start having short-term memory problems. I had to carry around a little notebook and record things because I couldn't remember conversations I had with people. My brain was processing really slow. Like you ask a patient a question and it takes them a whole 2 minutes to answer. That was me. And I was the main income earner for my family. So it was really, really difficult to go from caring for people, and all of a sudden you can't use diagnoses. So anyway, forget that. So I had slurred speech. I had difficulty identifying objects. A year later, I'm being treated, but a year later, I start having balance problems and I'm using a cane. I'm only 46. It was very, very humbling. I had lost 25 pounds. In 2019, because I was still mentally not functioning the way I should, I could not renew my license as a nurse practitioner. So that dream was gone. And it's still a little hard, you know, even though I'm thankful for my life now, and I'm so very thankful for ASEA, it still hurts to kind of go over the story, you know.
Kathy, was that your choice not to renew your license, or were you?
I couldn't, because my memory, I couldn't trust myself to be safe with a patient. If I can't remember what a patient told me, if my brain isn't functioning the best, then how could I treat them with the best that they deserve? I just couldn't put anybody at risk. And so the best thing to do was to step down. And so then Ruth Roscoe, who I didn't know, told me, came up to me with a little flyer about ASEA, and I hadn't heard of it. And I thought, I don't understand how I could never have heard about redox molecules. I mean, I went to school. I go home with my little bit of brain capacity and I research on Google Scholar, redox molecules, reduction in oxidation, all of this research in the medical community, all of these years. I saw that it was valid. I saw that it wasn't going to hurt me. I'm refilling what my body already makes. Therefore, there's no allergic reaction. Therefore, it's not going to be affected by the boatload of medicines and supplements that I was taking. It won't hurt to try. So I tried. And it was one of the best decisions I ever made. Everything started changing. My brain started working. My slurred speech went away. My balance problems went away. My memory issues were no longer an issue. I didn't have to treat energy like money that I didn't have a lot of. I stay awake driving now. I mean, I mean, the list is so long. My health issues are too long, too long to state in this time frame, but they were quite long. And every single thing on that list has been addressed by these molecules. And there's at least 16 I've counted so far improvements in my own body due to these molecules. I am so, so thankful.
Wow. What a blessing. That's absolutely amazing. And for you know, what a serendipitous meeting that somebody was just sharing some information with you. You know, we never know whose lives we're going to affect, right? You know, but this is truly a blessing. And Nelda, thank you so much, Kathy, for that. I'm going to have Nelda come on and share. And then Dr. Lee, I would love for you to give an overview after Nelda shares and just kind of explain a little bit. You do a beautiful job with the science, explaining it so that people can understand what this is, the simplicity and also the complexity of it, you know, because it's something in every cell of our body. It kind of runs our body, but it can sometimes be a little difficult to understand. So you do a wonderful job. So Nelda, if you will, come in and share your story with us.
And good evening, everyone. I'm Nelda from Lubbock, Texas. I have been a registered nurse for 26 years, and I basically had a friend, had some health issues. And so I just was helping her out. And in that quest for the knowledge of her health issues, she stumbled across ASEA, and she shared it with me. And so I just began taking it for preventive measures. I just wanted energy and endurance as a nurse. We all need that. So I just began to take it. But my real ASEA journey began when Leland Duck rode into town on a Sunday afternoon into Lubbock. And it was just a fabulous day. Like I said, I had a quest for knowledge. He invited me to attend a regional in Frisco, Texas. I did that. I committed to attend and realized what we had in our hands. I had no idea after 24 years of nursing at that point that there was something this monumental in cellular health. So it woke me up, came back, and, you know, I was used to seeing a lot of people and still am people on, you know, 25 to 30 meds every day. They are taking care of their symptoms. But when I found out about our molecules, it just changed everything because I prefer to go to the root of the problem instead of just masking and taking care of the symptoms. I don't want to mask an illness. And so it was a monumental decision when I came back from Frisco to share these molecules. So I have just began to share my knowledge with the world. But I can truly say that going in to begin taking ASEA, it was for a couple of selfish reasons, just energy, endurance. And then I began to see energy, endurance, mental focus, flexibility, I mean, on and on, less discomfort. And so I began to share that. And to me, that is a very special blessing that we have. We have another option besides all the medications and toxins that we are already placing inside our bodies. So that's basically how my ASEA journey began.
Wow. And Nelda, you're setting the world on fire, sharing it with everybody. It's just amazing. And I love a couple of things that you say. You know, this is a bioreplenishment agent. We are getting to the root of a lot of things. You know, as a physician, especially as a pain physician, I've written thousands of prescriptions over the years, well, at least hundreds, but probably thousands. And all of them came with side effects and warnings and whatnot. You know, this is totally non-toxic. And, you know, you guys, there's no such thing as a Tylenol deficiency or a morphine deficiency or anything like that. But there can be a deficiency of redox signaling molecules. There can be an imbalance. So Dr. Lee, can you come on and give us a little explanation for people who aren't familiar with the science about what these are and why it's so important for us to replenish them?
I'd be happy to. You know, what we're talking about with all of this and what you've heard is the whole essence of cellular health. We have brains, we think, you know, we have sensory input, and we can make decisions about our state. The question is, how does a cell know it's in trouble? If the swimming pool that everything in the cell is swimming in is toxic, how does the cell know that it needs to do something about that? And that's the essence of what we call cellular communication. And what happens is there's there's ways that the cell will signal. Think of it as a smoke alarm. If the smoke alarm in your house goes off, you don't get a ladder and go up to it and punch the button and turn it off and go back to bed. It's alarming for a reason. And yet that's what we do, is when the smoke alarms in our life go off and we have symptoms, that's what, you know, we've been talking about, is these symptoms that show up. We think that if we go to a, and I'm not doing this in any disrespectful way, we go see a physician or a health professional and we want to get something that will take the pain away or that will stop the alarming and the discomfort or whatever it is. And by and large, I realize we're painting with somewhat of a broad brush, but by and large, that's the focus of what we would call traditional healthcare today. Well, the cell has mechanisms and means whereby it can signal, it can communicate, and it doesn't do that because it has a brain. It does it because it has electrons. It has an oxidative state. There's a state of oxidation that it recognizes, and it knows how to respond based upon that biochemistry. The problem is that when those signaling molecules that are passing those electrons along the pathway, just like electrons are, you know, down an electrical wire, when those become dysfunctional, when they're not loud enough, when they're muted, in any regard, when they're dysfunctional, then they can't carry the signal, so the cell doesn't know how to respond to the smoke alarm. It doesn't know what to do or how to process that information. And so what happens downstream is there's a lack of response. We call that an antioxidant response, or that's one of them. And basically, that's called gene expression. Again, back to the question, how does your DNA know to respond? How does it know to produce the proteins that it needs to react to changing conditions that your cell is living in? Well, it does it through these signaling pathways that express gene activity that then produce a result that then correct the problem. And that's what redox signaling is all about. It's about the reduction and the oxidation. That's where the term redox comes from, at the biochemical level, so that the cell can maintain or restore what's called balance, or a functional balance, or what we call homeostasis. When I get out of homeostasis, then all these things that you've been listening to here from these fine nurse servants of ours start to happen. And then we call that dis-ease, or just disease. But it's an out of balance, unresponsive, or inability to respond way of dealing with those issues, and then disease results. One of the neat things about this whole technology, and it just has to do with the science, is we don't need to speak about specific diseases. What we speak about is the cell responding as it's supposed to. It's like waking up the inner doctor. When the doctor inside awakens, it can fix its own problems. And then whatever the symptoms are, whatever the smoke alarm signals are, those correct themselves and the alarm goes off. That's the beauty of redox signaling. So I hope that's a good overview.
I thought that was great. Thank you for that, Lee. Now I'm going to turn the show over to our beautiful Ann Glenn and her handsome husband, Jim. And you're going to run up. Sorry, Drogo.
We're going to take care of those dogs.
This way I can mute and you don't have to listen to the shepherds. But yeah, let's have a question and answer.
Yeah.
You know, I just want to bring up real quick. I have, unfortunately, have had too many surgeries. I have been in the hospital too much. And I will say that you guys are, anybody who's been a patient in a hospital, love the doctors, but you guys are the real heroes. And you guys are the ones that do the care day in and day out of the people that really need it. And I know that when I was hospitalized, again, with my 10 back surgeries, you guys are heroes. So I just want to say thank you so much for how much you guys sacrifice. A lot of times you guys don't get the glory. The big doctors do, right? And the big dentists like Dr. Lee. But you guys are the heroes. But I want to ask you real quick, each of you, Suzanne first, how do you share these molecules with either a patient or with a friend, or however you want to do for each of y'all? How do you do that?
Well, Right now, my husband and I live full time in an RV resort in Houston, Texas. It's about 4 miles from one of the largest medical centers in the world. And we purposely moved here because we felt like that we could be a blessing to others by moving here. And every day we get that opportunity. And some people are open and some people aren't. You have to be a good listener before you can share anything. And so we share this with people who have a need, who want to listen. And many times people who are here because they're here being treated with a huge protocol, they're educated. They're highly educated about their protocol and what molecular health means. So I have found in the last 3 months, people are looking for this. Mm. When you start talking about how it's going to protect, help protect their body so that they can thrive through an issue, their ears perk up. So that's what I talk about, help them to thrive through their journey.
And so, by the way, I like your necklace. It's kind of flashing all over the place.
Yeah, it's very bling bling.
Dory.
Kind of like it's your Memorial Day bling bling.
Well, and you know who's going to want it, don't you?
He does want it.
I know. Maureen wants anything that goes bling bling or anything that she can dress up like a princess.
That's right.
That's right.
I just want to take a second and thank you guys, because you know what? Thank you for doing that, Jim, because nurses make doctors look good. It's just so true.
Absolutely. And I remember when Maureen, you know, you'll appreciate this. I remember when I was in nursing school thinking, you know, someday I'm going to teach a doctor something, you know? And this is the greatest thing about this, you know, because most physicians don't have a clue about this. Right?
Nope. Yeah. They're my age. They didn't learn it in med school. You know, we had the Krebs cycle, but somehow this got passed over. Yeah, it was later that they realized that there was
left the bedside manners off to the side. You know, it's amazing you said that, Suzanne, that a lot of nurses have to be great listeners. And you typically are the ones that listen to the patient and then relay that to the doctors, correct?
In a way that people can understand it.
You translate.
Right. In a language that means something to that person, right? Something that they can relate to.
And how many people just want to be heard? Well, how many people just want to be heard, you know?
Yeah.
And how many people, like where I was, I'll be frank with you, I had no hope. I kind of feel like Kathy Davis, I had no hope where I was 6 years ago. And I am just so thankful that my best friend shared this with me. Doria, real quick, how do you, and we may have some repeating here, but I love the different, I know Kathy Davis will, because I've heard her before, but she just has, and nurses always have, especially teaching nurses, and my mother was an RN as well, and my dad was a doctor. So, and I've got a sister that's an LVN, a brother an LVN, so there's a lot of medical. My hands are too big. I couldn't see putting my hand in somebody's mouth. My dad was an oral surgeon. But Doria, how do you explain this to anybody?
Yes. So, Jim, I want to go back a little bit on my testimony. You know, we were talking about I took this for preventive reasons. Right. And I'm meeting a lot of people that say I have no health challenges. And so once I was on the redox, I didn't realize that I was compensating for a very, very long time and not realizing that I had all those aches and pains and I had the fatigue and I had the lack of energy and the lack of focus until I got on the redox and realized that it was those things were going away. So I, you know, I meet people that, you know, say, I don't have any health challenge. And I say, you know, this works at the cellular level. We have cells in every part of our body and every organ and every tissue. And you can have something brewing at the cellular level and not see anything for years to come. So, you know, I said, you know, it's better to go ahead and, you know, get on the product, but, you know, and allow it to, you know, it works every time. It works, yeah. You know, helps people. But I just like, you know, like I'm going to say it as fluently as Lee says it, but, you know, I call it the little GPS. It knows exactly where to go in the body. It's able to detect the cellular damage. It's able to repair it and restore it. And so that's what I, you know, share with people.
By the way, I call those people that don't think they have anything wrong until people, mm-hmm. until people, until something happens, yeah. until you fall flat on your face and pass out, something will happen. So if you want to wait until something happens, but we love talking to people about being proactive for their own health. So thank you, Doria. Kathy Davis, how do you share these molecules with people?
I explained that the molecules are a refill of what your body already makes. A lot of people today are afraid of what's in it. Is it going to interact with any medications I'm already taking? Right. So I explained to them, it's a refill. Your body is making this and you're refilling it. And so therefore there are no, allergic reactions and things like that. So I say that, but then I also explain that, how, you know, how a person can have an infection, they can have a sore. I take that word back. They can have a sore maybe on their foot and their body isn't doing anything about it. You know, so why is that? Well, sometimes as we get a little older, our body doesn't communicate like it once did. And so that little sore can get out of control, because the communication did not get to the white blood cell army that there's something going on there where that sore is. So when you drink the molecules, you're basically drinking that communication and your body goes, oh my goodness, there's a sore right there on that foot that we haven't been addressing. We didn't know it was there. We did not get the communication. And so now we're going to deal with that sore because we're aware. So they're communicating molecules. We're deficient in our communicating. So our body doesn't know to deal with certain things because it's not aware.
Right. Now, so it's like the missing link. That's why so many medical are listening and looking at it. Yeah. Very good.
Thank you. Thank you, Kathy. All right, Nelda, how do you do it?
Okay. So I love it. I weave ASEA into my day every day, just into my life. So if I have just met Maureen, I would just say, you know, hey,
I'd pray for you if you just met Maureen.
Okay, let's go with
pick somebody else. It's not so hard.
But anyone, honestly, I would just say, you know, first of all, I'm very interested in the person, so I'm listening to them. That honestly is one of the best things to do. So they open up and they may say, oh, I'm good, I'm real good, you know, with their health. Or they may just start saying, well, I'm trying this item because I'm on this type of diet, you know, gluten-free because I have such and such. And then just the other day I said, well, you know, I had that. I used to have that. And that person said, she just kind of looked at me like, I've been taking medications for 25 years and you used to have that. And I've been suffering for 25 years. And then I just say, have you heard of Redox? Very simple. Keep it simple. And then I just say, when would you have time to watch a 7-minute video? And I keep it simple, and that's what I do. And then I do a 3-way call so that they can look and listen first, listen to the testimonials. And I don't give them too much because they're not going to remember everything. But if I send them a video, they will be able to look at it, open up any testimonial that they're interested in, and go from there. But I do say, in a nutshell, it is the communication between your trillions of cells. Without it, little else matters.
Right. And for those that are new, the 7-minute video is an overview of what redox signaling is. And then if you stay on there longer, you can listen to up to 80 different stories, short little 5-7 minute stories. I know Kathy has her story on. I'm sure several others on the panel do. Jim is number 19. You can look. It's called Discomfort for the Back. And you can hear his story, which was before he lost 69 pounds. So that's just a great way for y'all to learn, you know, there are other people out there that are seeing these miraculous changes. So that's awesome. So I was going to ask a couple questions. I was thinking about you, Kathy, when you described your drive when you went to Frisco. We all went to Frisco, Texas, remember? And you were sharing with me about you were able to make that long drive. Before, you used to have to take a nap along the way, right? I mean, you couldn't even imagine driving that far. And you made it all the way with no issues. And I know when you started on the prod, I remember that night and the different things you'd done before to take care of your health. And you started at like 4 ounces, right? At the very beginning?
I did. 2 ounces in the morning and 2 in the evening.
Yeah. So were you already at 6 ounces by the time you got on that drive, or had you not gotten graduated yet to 6 ounces?
No, I was still on 4. I was still on 4 ounces. Yeah. Normally my husband would have to do most of the driving because I had difficulty staying awake driving 3/4 of the time. Any long trip, he did the driving. I did very little and he did most. So for me to drive from the San Antonio area all the way up to Frisco by myself, with no coffee and to stay awake, I just sang the whole way. It was great. It was so good. And then I stayed up late. I went to my friend's house where I was staying. And then I went to the hotel to meet, a lot of people who were there for the conference. I went back to the hotel about 10 o'clock at night and came to the conference the next day. It was very, very exciting.
That's great. And for today, that's great. Today you maintain 6 or 8?
Now I do about 8. I would say I do 2 in the morning, 1 at night, and then I nebulize about maybe 6 mLs at night. And so just to kind of, because it's more effective when you nebulize. And so I've been doing that and I've noticed an even greater improvement.
Yeah. So, and a reminder, we're not claiming to cure, diagnose, or treat. We're just saying give your body back what it's been lacking since puberty and then let the body do all the work. So that's awesome. I had one other question maybe a round table could answer. You know, your nurses, I remember when Jim, because I was with him for 9 of his 10 back surgeries. That doesn't mention that also his gallbladder had taken out. So unfortunately, we didn't know about all this years ago when I watched him suffer. And so the 13 of 19 years married, all I saw was Jim medicated and surgeries, missing a lot of time at home, sleeping a lot, naps, obviously medicated, all those side effects. You know, the liver's having to take on a toll when you have to metabolize all of those. So as nurses, why do you think people would not just jump onto this when you share it? And we go through this all the time. It's non-toxic. It's part of the human body. We're just happen to have it in a bottle. Why do you think people are not giving it a try? Why do you think that they are, they don't research the list of medications sometimes. They just take them. They don't research what garbage is inside a Big Mac. They just eat it. It just behooves me why some will just not. You have to really find those open-minded people that look outside the box and are open to an alternative. And thank God we heard of this, because Jim, I'm not sure would still be here today if he was still popping 530 pills that he used to take every month. So maybe y'all could all share as nurses, if you've racked your brain around that.
Or how do you deal with that?
Why people aren't coming forward to do it.
Sometimes it's people cannot wrap their head around the value. They don't understand the actual value. We often tell people a SIA costs about the same amount as a cup of Starbucks coffee. It kind of does.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's a good analogy. Some people, though, just like you just said, Anne, some people are on so much medication that their mind is clouded by that. Some people also have given away their own authority over their own body to the practitioners. I'm going to say that lightly. Sorry, Maureen, but not you. But, and I can say that with all honesty, that Many times physicians don't understand it. You know, if they don't know, they don't know. Mm-hmm. So they're not educated enough, and patients aren't educated enough. So let me tell y'all a story really quick. When Pat, my husband Pat, had his aortic valve replaced in 2017, I didn't leave his bedside for the entire time he was there, including while he was there in ICU. Well, my husband's my husband, you know, he belongs to me. And even though he was supposed to not have anything by mouth, every time I went to see him, he drank a pouch of ASEA.
Awesome.
Okay. Because he's my husband, right? And they would not have, you know, the doctor, the nurses there, they would not have been the widow who didn't have their husband, right? I knew what I knew. So I took care of my husband. I made sure that he came home with me without a pacemaker and on no medication, not 15 drugs, right? That people normally go home with. He went home on a prescription for one medication. Awesome. And in a month, he was off of it. So remember that your body belongs to you.
Right. Excellent.
That's some of what I run into, and that's my thoughts about it. So people need to be educated and take their health seriously, because it's so much easier to have than to try to get it back.
Exactly. It's cheaper.
And of course, the older we get, the more difficult it is. Right.
Yeah. Right. It's cheaper to be on this than it is to be not well, which I've seen.
Well, Maureen, you typically say what? It's until you've been ill, until you've had a major thing happen to you, people have, and I used to do a lot of disability insurance as a financial advisor. People have no idea what it costs to be sick or what it costs to recover from an injury.
It's awful. I remember when my husband was going through his illness, his life-threatening illness, and he was at that hospital that's very close to Suzanne. And I used to think, you know, we're blessed because we had two insurances. We had our insurance through the hospital and also insurance through the military. But it was unbelievable, you know, when we would see the bills that came through and just parking. I used to think, how do people
yes
parking every day? Yeah. You know,
$20 a day to park.
And when you're going every day, you know, that yeah. I was like, you know, we're blessed, but how are all these other people doing it? So yeah, it's amazing. Yeah. But I do want to say one thing about, and I'm sorry, I was distracted because we were talking about Legos, putting the molecules together like Legos in the comment. But, you know, I think one of the impediments to people taking this, at least for me, when I first got started, was it sounds stupid. It's made from, what are those Legos?
I was going to ask that, Maureen, about the salt water. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, that, you know, now at least it has, I usually have a pouch by me, you know, at least now it has the certification from Bioagilytics that talks about it having actually being certified to have redox molecules in it. But, you know, when we got started, you know, that was 8 years ago. It was blind. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. It was blind faith. You know, it, now, you know, because it doesn't taste like salt water and that you get an effect and it's like, well, I don't think that would happen if I was just drinking salt water, but it was a little bit of a leap of faith. So I think that was a hurdle that we can now get over. But the, you know, the most amazing thing, and you ladies can probably talk a little bit about this, is this stuff. Oh my gosh, this is a game changer.
Right. Yes.
Lather it and see what it does.
I never give someone one of those tubes without opening it and touching them with it.
Yes.
Exactly.
There's something magical about the human touch with those molecules, because people always feel a difference.
By the way, you can also put into a mister, a spray bottle, and mist your body with. There's something magical about that as well.
Yep. Right.
Yeah.
Will you say something else, Maureen? Oh, there we go. Yay.
And you know what? I have, when I'm signing up a new person, if they come on as an associate, I add, you can get 10 of these for $10. Right. And these are worth their weight in gold, because you know what?
They are.
Yeah, before we had the gel, you know, we would fill this and we would spritz it everywhere. And even now, there are things that I think respond better to the liquid.
Like, yeah.
We're not supposed to talk about that, but this action.
And any kind of open boo-boo.
Yeah, open boo-boos. Exactly. Things that you don't want to touch. Yeah.
Fabulous.
Do you mind if I ask, how do you deal with the fact, whoever wants to answer this, maybe Nelda or Doria, network marketing? Now, we have a show that we deal with that in a couple of weeks, but how did you guys deal with the fact that it's coming to the medical community, it's coming to the world from networking?
Or answer either question if you want to chime in.
Doria?
I say thank God. Thank God it went to the network marketing, because if we had not, because if it didn't go this way, we wouldn't have seen it. You know, I mean, it would have been, you know.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I mean,
I know what you're saying, but explain that for the people that don't know what you're saying.
Okay. So, you know, our company, you know, could have received a very sizable check for this. I mean, it was going to go the pharmaceutical route, and they could have easily received a nice check that would, you know, last for generations. And they said, you know, no to the, you know, the economical part of that, and said yes to the people. But even if they sold it by direct sales and put it on Walmart shelf, nobody would know what it would do. There's no testimonies. And so the best way to share this is through stories. And really, that's what caught my attention, was a testimony, you know, and that's how, you know, other than researching and realizing it was a non-toxic and, you know, a cellular, you know, product. But I'm thankful that it's a networking process. Okay. Yeah.
Kathy, how would you deal with the fact that it's not FDA? And then I want to ask you a pointed question, because when you got your memory back, you've told me multiple times that you could go back and get your family nurse practitioner license back, correct? Why won't you?
Well, it's not God's plan. If God wanted me to go back, he would tell me. And my one of my goals each day is to always be obedient to what God wants me to do. So that's the real answer. The second answer would be, I just don't want to go back to prescribing things that I know have side effects in patients' lives. And I can't go back to possibly, like, what if I made a mistake? You know, what if, you know, I prescribed and I caused injury, or it didn't go well with that patient? I can't go back to that weight. And ASEA is safe. It is safe for everybody. Not one person can be hurt by it. And I like that. I don't want to go back to the old life. And I think God had things that he wanted me to learn from that life. And I try to apply all that I've learned from that. To having been ill, it's very humbling. And so now I live very thankful, and I try to remain humble and obedient.
And so you very right. much are.
That's right.
Now, how do you deal with the fact that it's not an FDA approved thing?
Well, to me, the LDL 50 has a lot to do with that for me. We are
explain
in an
FDA
approved facility. Well, the LD 50 is the toxic level of any medication that comes out to market, but ASEA does not have that. We do not have that in Redox. There is no toxic level, because there's no toxins. It is native to the body, non-toxic. And so that takes care of that.
Does every medication have an LD 50?
Yes. Every medication has an LD 50. That's the toxicity level that would cause death. And
what about over the counter stuff?
Every medication does that I'm aware of. But going back to the why is it MLM, and I would say we are next level marketing. And then I usually ask someone if they say, is this, network marketing? And I usually say, what do you mean by that? Because there's usually a story. They've had some kind of experience, a very negative experience. And I want them to tell me about that, because it's really not about ASEA. It's about an experience that they have had. So I just say, you know, we move product. We don't move money. And then, you know, to me, if they have an issue, then, it's their issue, not mine. And so I just move on from there.
Suzanne, is this a pyramid scheme?
No.
Suzanne.
Did you say?
Hear that a lot. I mean, people have all these old tapes playing in their mind, like what Nelda said.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I do the exact same thing Nelda said. What do you think a pyramid scheme is? Did you have an experience with something you thought was a pyramid scheme?
And then one more thing I would say, you know, I would never be involved. I would not place my license in jeopardy. I would not be a part of that.
Exactly.
I worked way too hard for this license. Are you kidding me?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I renewed my license a few weeks ago, and you know, we have to do 20 hours of CEUs. You know, you still have to keep your license up. And I haven't worked in a hospital in years, but do you think I'm going to let that license lapse, or that I would ever risk my license for that? No way.
Okay, I know a lot of people are going to want to know, how would you share it? Like Maureen, sometimes you've talked about this as far as sharing it with a doctor, sharing it with a nurse, with a medical professional, of which you guys all are. How would, and we've only got like 4 minutes for my big song, how would you share it with someone in the medical professional? What is there anything, something different you would say to a medical professional?
Or give them, you know, would you give
usually,
them?
Yeah. It's usually a good idea to start off with, you don't know everything.
Yeah, if I would have told you that.
You don't want to do that.
I'm just playing you guys. But you know what? That can be a tough nut to crack, you know? So, I'd love to hear the nurses, how the nurses approach other healthcare professionals. So
I would say I treat them like anyone else. First, I want them to have an experience so that then they can share with their patients. The other thing is, you know, I send people to amazingmolecules.com, scroll down, and then you can, that addresses the pyramid scheme. So, you know, we've got our tools, use those tools, and, you know, it makes it easy when you're doing what we do. We have the tools, so use those tools. Use that realredoxresults.com 7-minute video. You don't have to be in there, you know, spinning your wheels with someone when you already have the tool and all the knowledge. I mean, make it easy, keep it simple, and keep moving.
That's right. That's right.
That's awesome, Nelda.
I wanted to say before we're about to close is, you know, we get paid in goosebumps, don't we, Kathy? You know, when you see someone like Kirk Kennedy seeing results, and that's what is matters. Or I think of Nelda, isn't it, the Shannon that you shared, and now that grandchild is impacted. I mean, that is means more than any great fancy thing we could ever get out of the business. I'm sure Dory and Suzanne, you've seen your own husband. You know, I got my own husband back. I know Maureen got hers. So,
and Lee got his wife back.
That's right. Excuse me. Yeah, Lee, your wife's is quite remarkable within 3 weeks of such changes. So, you know, Dory, I'm sure you think of stories that you've been paid in goosebumps. Just that, those, oh my gosh, I cannot believe this miracle.
I just want to add real quick, just remember, everybody out there in the world, doctors and nurses, frankly, everybody, they're human as well. Everybody has issues. And I think, Nelda, you hit it on the head. And I'm sure we would all agree. That's why we take this Renew with us everywhere we go. Mm-hmm. Give someone an experience. Don't go in there thinking you're going to get all their patients and all of that. They're human. They have issues. They have struggles.
Yeah.
You know?
Exactly.
We got exciting. 1 minute before my big song.
Well, and before your big song, who do we have next weekend?
Who do we have next week, Lee?
Lee, tell us.
Lee, you got this one. You're muted.
All right. Let's see. We've got two chiropractors. It's our chiropractor night, right?
Awesome. Yes.
Yay.
Good.
So you've got someone from Asia, correct?
No, that's the next week.
No, that's next week's the 11th.
Well, no. Next week is June. So it's only going to be June 4.
Right. Okay. We've got, I'm sorry. My bad. We've got, I was skipping a week. We've got Foster Malmed and Dr. Aaron Kaufman. These two are really, they're Kaufman's fun together.
Kaufman's a DO.
Right. He's a doctor of osteopathy.
He mixed the two
up. Yeah, he's not a...
He's got a DO and a...
Well, let's just go ahead and make him a chiropractor. He won't mind. I'm sure he's listening. He won't care. But ladies, I want to thank you so much. We have the Aussies. They're going to come on right after the song. Guys, it's been an awesome time. We're going to be doing this again. And so if you guys don't mind, it is Memorial Day weekend, and I am going to share my screen and play a song. So I hope that the music comes out clearly. It's about a 4-minute song. So here we go. I really pray you guys enjoy this.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Pop off after it. Happy Memorial. Here we go.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go. To love pure and chaste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. No matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know man, scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage. To bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to run where the brave dare not go, though the road be forever too high, to try though your way would end weary.
Awesome.
That was fabulous.
That awesome. Now Lee, just to clarify, on June 11th, you have a chiropractor you invited to come on. So we'll have Kaufman and Malmed, and then your immediate week after is your person that you know. Right.
Awesome. Dr. Ray Dixon from from Thailand.
Very good. Right. This will be new to us. So this is great.
So guys, thank you so much.
Fabulous.
Nurses, you're our heroes. We love you all.
Thanks,
and
everyone.
Thank you so much. Bye. To
the Aussies.
Thank you.
Such an honor.
Thank you guys so much.
Great honor.
God bless.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. See you next week.
Next week. All right.